In this presentation, we will discuss about feldspathoids. Bowen's reaction series represents the normal crystallization of magma when it is silica rich. It is due to this abundance of silica that we are able to get quartz in the end. But what would happen if the silica content is low in magma? Well, we would have no quartz and no feldspar, and the mineral which will form is called feldspathoids. The chief chemical difference between feldspars and feldspathoids lies in the silica content. And if free silica is present in the magma, feldspathoid would combine with alkalis to form feldspar. Feldspathoids like nepheline hence have less silica content than feldspar such as albite, and this is evident in these pie diagrams as well in the formula. This is true for all feldspathoids, like here when the silica content is low, the same cations combine in low silica to form leucite instead of orthoclase. Feldspathoid structure consists of rings of AlO4 and SiO4 tetrahedron that are connected to form a fully polymerized framework which encloses cavities containing large cations. These cavities also form channels that pass throughout the structure. Sheets of such rings are bonded to each other by apical oxygen to form cavities and channels, as shown here in the image of single sheet structure of nepheline labeled A and double sheet structure labeled B. Feldspathoids also contain some of the unusual and rare anions. For example, cancrenite incorporates carbonate ions, sodalite has chloride ions, and lazurite has sulfate, sulfide, and chloride ions. Also, in feldspathoids, there is a general increase in the openness of silica structure when compared to feldspar. This is expressed in specific gravity of feldspathoid minerals. Let us now see some feldspathoid minerals. Leucite contains 4-member and 6-member rings of tetrahedra, and the channels so formed do not intersect. It crystallizes in cubic crystal system and shows conchoidal fracture. Nepheline exhibits highly distorted 6-member rings and crystallizes in hexagonal crystal system. Insertion of cations in the channels causes the distortion of the framework. Sodalite is easy to identify due to its blue color. Its structure is similar to that of leucite, but the channels formed here intersect with each other to form larger cavities where the chloride, sulfate, or sulfide ions may reside. This is lazurite, and its typical distinguishing rich blue color makes this mineral one of the most distinctive and attractive minerals of all time. World's best lazurite comes from northeastern Afghanistan, and its color comes from sulfur. Coming to occurrences of feldspathoids, all feldspathoids are primary constituents in igneous rocks, except lazurite, which has contact metamorphic origin in limestone. Feldspathoids react with quartz to form feldspar, and due to this, primary quartz and feldspathoids can never be found in the same rock, and so feldspathoids do not occur in silica-rich rocks like granite. There are also several uses of feldspathoid minerals. Powdered lazurite was formerly used as an ultramarine paint pigment. However, today ultramarine is produced synthetically. Lapis lazuli is a highly prized ornamental stone and was one of the first gemstones to be ever worn as jewelry. It is a mixture of lazurite with calcite, pyroxene, and small amounts of golden pyrite, which can be seen in the image. With this, I end this presentation on feldspathoids.